This is another Paccar Engine Knowledge Minute. Priming the EPA 2013 MX engine with the MityVac 7430. After performing a fuel system service, return the engine to the normal operating configuration. Be sure the MityVac canister is empty and the air supply lever is in the off position. Be sure there's an adequate amount of fuel in the tank to prime the system. Disconnect the fuel return line on the truck and install the special tool hose V50-1096-1081-1020 between the fuel return port on the engine and the MityVac. Do not start, do not even crank the engine with the truck's return fuel line disconnected. Once the return line is disconnected, cap the return line with the plastic cap supplied in the fuel priming kit. Install the fuel priming kit return hose, part number V50-1096-1081-1020, to the engine return fuel manifold. Now install the green tether to both the V50-1096-1081-1020 and to the chassis return hose. This is to remind you to return the engine and the hoses to their normal configuration before attempting to start. Make sure the shop air pressure is less than 150 PSI. Then connect the MityVac to the shop air hose and open the valve on the MityVac. Monitor the MityVac collection canister during the process to prevent overfill. Continue evacuating for 5 minutes or until the MityVac canister is full. At about 1 to 1.5 minutes into the process, the primary fuel filter will begin to fill. Once it starts, it will fill quickly. When this happens, it is not an indication that the process is complete. Continue to wait the full 5 minutes or until the MityVac canister is full. As the process continues, you will see lots of bubbles and even foam in the clear plastic hose that is part of the priming kit. This is not an indicator of the progress of the process. When the 5 minutes is up or when the canister is full, turn off the MityVac air valve and disconnect the kit. Remove the tether. Remove the priming kit suction hose. Remove the plastic cap. And reconnect the truck's return line to the return fuel manifold. Manually operate the hand priming pump on the truck for 10 full strokes. Then tighten the manual priming pump firmly before attempting to start. If the engine does not start within 20 seconds, operate the hand pump an additional 10 full strokes. Then crank the engine again in an attempt to start.